throughout the region, including in Afghanistan. The new request to have him dissolve Iraq will hopefully Afghanistan. Excuse me, Senator Obama, it picks up on a point that's already been made. Do you think more U.S. troops should be sent to Afghanistan? How many and when?
Yes, I think we need those troops. I've been saying that for over a year now. And I think they'll be able to do it as quickly as possible because it's been acknowledged by the commanders on the ground. The situation is getting worse. It's not better. We have the highest fatalities among U.S. troops this past year than any time since 2002. And we are seeing major offensives taking place. Al-Qaeda and Taliban crossing the border and attacking our troops in a brazen fashion. They are feeling alone. And we cannot separate Afghanistan from Iraq because what our commanders have said is we don't have the troops right now to deal with Afghanistan. So I would send 2 additional brigades to Afghanistan. I'll keep in mind that we have 4 times the number of troops in Iraq where somebody had any major demand left before coming.
Thank you. Our security requirements are, and I know what our needs are. And so the point is,
that we will prevail in Afghanistan, but we needed a strategy and we needed to succeed. But the important thing is, if we suffer defeat in Iraq, General Petraeus predicts we will. If we adopt Senator Obama's set date for withdrawal, then that will have a calamitous effect on Afghanistan and American national security. We have interest in the region, so Obama doesn't seem to understand there's a connection between the two.
I have some good news that is that for the two of you, you all are even on time. We've gone at it for a few minutes. I'm not
quite well about that.
But the bad news is, I'm on a 5-minute thing to bridle. So, anyhow, we'll adjust as we get there. But the amount of time is even new. That goes to a tremendous news, Dr. McCain. What is your reading on what's on Iran right now for the security of the United States?
My reading, the threat from Iran, is that if Iran acquires nuclear weapons, it's an existential threat to the state of Israel. And it is a threat to the region because the other countries in the region will feel a compelling requirement to acquire nuclear weapons as well. Now, we cannot allow a second Holocaust. Let's just make that very clear. But I have proposed for a long time, and I had a conversation with foreign leaders about forming a league of democracies. Let's be clear. Let's have these breaks off. The Russians are preventing significant tension in the United Nations Security Council. I propose a league of democracies, a group of people, a group of countries that share common interests, common values, common ideals, and they also control a lot of the world's economic power. We could impose significant, meaningful, painful sanctions on the Iranians that I think could have a beneficial effect. The Iranians have a lousy government, so therefore their economy is lousy, even though they have significant oil revenues. So I am convinced. First of all, I'm going to jump up this mountain first of all. So he may not be the right person to jump. But I reserve it's on Twitter or around the issue of nuclear weapons. Again, it may not work, but if it doesn't work, then we have strengthened our ability to form alliances to impose the sanctions that Senator McCain just mentioned. And when we haven't done it, we're North Korea. Let me just give you one more example. In North Korea, we cut ourselves. They're a member of the National Security. We can't deal with them. And you know what happened? They went
Precondition.